Greetings. I recently made a video highlighting the fantasy of Surah 1047 and Surah 3524, which claim every nation has received a prophet who brought scriptures from the Allah of the Quran. The replies from Mohammedans are kind of funny. Let's take a look at one exchange. This poster, the greatest ummah, makes an interesting claim. Essentially, when challenged to produce any proof of prophets from Allah outside of Judaism and the Torah and Bible, he offers up Hinduism as a religion of Allah and the Vedas as a book or books from Allah. Let's read what he actually wrote. So this is his text in the middle. So according to you, there was no prophet sent to humanity for millions of years. Look, if you use little bit of your intelligence, you would see this fact. For example, the Vedas of the Hindu religion are millions of years old, and some scholars say thousands of years old, older than the Bible. So where did this book come from? Because if you read the Vedas, it clearly talks about the oneness of God and even prophesies the advent of Muhammad. So first, he rationalizes over millions of years God must have sent prophets to humanity. Evidently, according to Islam, human history is millions of years old. Look again at what he wrote. So according to you, there was no prophet sent to humanity for millions of years. Look, if you use little bit of your intelligence, you would see this fact. For example, the Vedas of the Hindu religion are millions of years old. Next, he claims that the Vedas of Hinduism is millions of years old. But it gets better. Why does he even bring up the Vedas? Think about it. This Mohammedan is trying to claim Allah sent the Vedas. There is no other reason to do so. He is attempting to support Surah 1047 and Surah 3524, which claims Allah sent a warner, a messenger, and a prophet to every nation. So I called him out on that very fact, that he is attempting to imply that the Vedas are from Allah to prove Surah 1047 and Surah 3524. I understand the need to support the claims of Surah 1047. Really, I do. You live with a very fragile absolute. The Quran is perfect, and any single error disproves it. In your argument, now you claim the Vedas of Hindu is a scripture from your Allah. So you are claiming pagan religions are also from your Allah. Is this really the argument you must make to defend the claim of Surah 1047? Are there no actual prophets and scriptures that can be named? The amazing thing is, when challenged, he then turns around and tries to deny that this is the claim he was making. Look, I never claimed that the Vedas is from Allah. Maybe it is, or maybe it is not. But the fact remains that a message of one God has always been there before the Judaism came on the scene. Do you really believe that for millions of years the Almighty kept the humanity in darkness by not sending any prophets? I think this is ridiculous. See? He says, I never claimed that the Vedas is from Allah. And then, having denied his own claim, he moves on. But he cannot, and does not, offer one single scrap of evidence, having denied that the Vedas is from Allah, after he claimed it was. But he is not deterred, having failed by first claiming, then denying the Vedas is evidence, he changes arguments to this. Your observation that the Quran has only mentioned the prophets of a particular region is absolutely correct. The fact is that the Quran has generally not informed its first addressees of any messenger or prophet. On the contrary, the Quran has only referred to those prophets and messengers who were either directly known to its first addressees through their historical traditions, or were indirectly known through them. What? Try and read that. That just makes no sense. Watch my video and pay attention. I state that only Jewish prophets were sent by God. I never say the Quran only mentions prophets from a particular region. This is just another dodge and more deception. My video highlights the fantasy in the Quran, which claims every nation has a prophet and scripture unique to that nation, from Allah. The Quran says, never was a nation, never was, did not exist. There has never been a nation that did not have a prophet and a scripture sent to it from Allah. That's the Quran's claim, and it is pure, unadulterated fantasy. The next excuse is that only those prophets known to the people were mentioned in the Quran. But think about what his message really says. Mohammed could only tell about men that he had learned about. I thought an all-knowing Allah wrote the Quran, not some man who needed education to determine who he knew about. In summary, the poster first claims the Vedas of Hinduism is from Allah, or are from Allah, which means Hinduism is from Allah. Next, the poster denies his very own argument and claims he never said the Vedas was from Allah, which just doesn't make sense. If you're going to offer it up as the evidence to prove your claim of your book, you are making the claim. That's the whole point. It is just a downright lie to claim, oops, I was caught with this stupid idea. It's not a fact. It doesn't make sense. When it's challenged, it wilts. That failed, he reverts to dogmatic, unsupported assertion wrapped in exaggeration. Surah 1047 and Surah 3524 both repeat the fantasy that every nation has had a prophet from Allah, a prophet who brought scriptures, scriptures that should have manuscript evidence that teach the message Allah is one alone. But there is no evidence to support this claim, only baseless conjecture. If there is no evidence to support the Quran's claim, it is only a fantasy. The burden of proof is on Islam to provide evidence, proof, names of prophets, nations they were sent to, documentation, manuscript evidence, not just baseless, unsupported claims. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.